We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we are talking KBS Iron Shafts. Now, hopefully you've heard the name KBS before. They're a brand that's been in business since 2008, but the brains behind the brand, Kim Braley, was a shaft legend well before he started up this company. Originally at KBS, they started out by just making iron shafts, but they've evolved into a company who makes shafts for every single club in your bag. From drivers to fairways to hybrids, irons, wedges, and even putters. And they're aimed at all types and speed of golfers. So it doesn't matter who you are, whether you're a tour player, an amateur, you can fit in the KBS range absolutely perfectly. DJ Mickelson, Shane Lowry, Justin Rose, Adam Scott, Gary Woodland, they've all played KBS iron shafts and won with them amongst tons of other players. But with 14 iron shafts in the range, it can be pretty confusing, Neil.
Yeah, there's a lot there, isn't there, Simon? 14's quite a lot to have just in an iron category. Mm-hmm. And hopefully we can simplify it down and help the golfers that are watching to make their best choice to suit their game.
Okay, so that's what we are going to show you in this video. It's how each of the KBS iron shafts compare in terms of data, but also give you insight into who each of the shafts is actually aimed at. Let's get started then, Neil. Let's get you out. You start creating data, and I'll tell people about the three pillar shafts within the KBS family. Okay, the KBS Tour Shaft. This is like the mothership of the whole of the KBS brand. This is where it all began. This is a consistent step pattern shaft, which basically means that this shaft the whole way along has steps exactly the same size. It's a higher balance point shaft, so that basically means that the balance point is nearer to the grip than what it is to the tip, and that gives a slightly softer feel. It's good for smoother, less aggressive transition players. And it gives a really good feel right at the top of the swing. It's a mid-launch, mid-spin shaft. And this very much is the Kim Braley signature shaft. So every other shaft that he has created, he always comes back to this to use it as his base model. And because it's not overly strong, it can really fit a very, very wide audience of players, from amateurs all the way through to tour players. And down here we have got a weight and swing speed guide. They are only guides. If we just run that forward then onto the C taper and the S taper. Now, KBS as a brand, these players' iron shafts, they are really aimed at changing balance points. So if you think about it like that, if the tour is the mid-launch, mid-spin, we have the C taper, which is the lowest launch, lowest spin, so it's stiffest in the tip section. Whereas the tour is the stiffest in the grip section, and then the S taper fits right in the very middle. What I love about KBS is that these three shafts, they're all the same weight, and they come in five different flexes. So if you've ever been for a club fitting before, and you've been told that you sit right on the fence between a regular and a stiff, then you have the R plus and the S plus that fit perfectly in there. Just to show you how these all compare, now this is just a guide. We have the tour here, which is mid-launch, mid-spin. We've got the C taper down here, which is your low launch, low spin. And then the S taper is just about here. You'll also notice there are some extra shafts. Okay, so there's a tour V. So basically, I've been speaking to their tour rep, and what he says is that because C taper is such a strong shaft, for players that like the ball flight that they get with that shaft, that just want a slightly softer feel, then the Tour V, which is a little bit lighter, is actually a really, really good fit. You'll also find that the KBS have got the Tour FLT, so flighted. That basically means that it's a tour shaft, but the long irons are going to launch a little bit higher, and the short irons are going to launch a little bit lower. We've also got three extra shafts up here at the top of the graph. Now, we'll come back and talk about those later, but first off, let's head out and let's see how Neil's getting on with his testing. Right, Neil, you've been out there for quite a while.
Certainly have.
How's it going?
Yeah, really good. I'm really, really enjoying it. The thing that strikes me, Simon, is I cannot believe the difference from the graphite through to the the C taper in
terms
of feel.
So is it a big difference?
Oh, huge.
Yeah.
The C taper is so strong, feels so much heavier.
Mm-hmm.
The graphite and your lighter, softer, feel like they've got more torque.
Okay.
You can see how the differences in shaft would definitely make a difference for the golfers, 100%.
Any favourites so far?
Yeah,
what stands out to you?
Okay. S taper feels great. Doesn't feel too strong, but gives me enough there where I feel like I'm under control of it.
Mm-hmm.
Great feeling, gosh, I feel like it loads quite well. I like the weight of it. I feel like if I was to use anything from what I've tested so far, this would be the one. C-taper feels a little bit too strong.
Mm-hmm.
Your graphite, the KBS Max, for another example, would be, it looked like very off
steep.
The naked eye,
mm-hmm.
too steep. A descent angle, really high peak height, so I don't think that would be a great fit for me.
Okay.
But I'm fascinated by how different they actually feel. It's huge.
Brilliant. Okay, well, I'll let you crack on and then we'll see you guys back inside where we can have a look at the data and then we can explain the other shafts in the family. Right, Neil, you've hit a ton of shots there. We've got three shafts up here at the top of our chart, the C taper light, the S taper light and the tour light. When would a player go lighter? Because these are 15 grams lighter than the standard stock models. Just talk us through it. When would a player go lighter?
Yeah, generally if you're looking for a little bit more launch, which mm-hmm. probably lead to a little bit more peak height and a steeper descent angle. Generally, Simon, the guy who needs help with getting golf ball airborne, basically, to get more ball flight.
Mm-hmm. So the strength of the player really affects whether you're going to go light or not.
Yeah, definitely. So your guy who's got that would benefit from this really would be your slower speeds generally.
Yeah, like players that don't really go after it. And also that lighter really goes hand in hand with age, doesn't it?
Yeah, just took the words right out of my mouth. That's a great point there, that as you get a little bit older, generally, you tend to lose a little bit of speed,
mm-hmm.
and that's where the lighter shaft can really, really help.
Great, okay. And just give us an idea about what sort of speed would be an average speed with the 7-iron.
Generally, mid-70s, I would say,
mm-hmm.
clubhead speed would be a rough guide. You have a few guys. I think tour average is roughly around about 89.
Okay.
You know, you see the odd guy that goes into the 90s when I do custom fitting sound, but generally, late 70s, early 80s would be...
Right, okay.
Be a good benchmark.
What I love about the light is that it gives people the ability to be able to play the same shaft throughout their career.
Mm.
So if you're a C taper guy now, as you age, then you can go into C taper light. If you're an S taper, then you can go into S taper light, which actually is a really, really nice idea.
And some guys, Sam, when you'll be surprised, a lot of guys, you think, oh, the heavier the shaft, the more you can feel the club head. You put a lighter shaft in a golfer's hands, and they'll say, oh, yeah, feels loads better straight away, I can feel where the club head is. So don't overlook the lighter shaft if you still maintain a little bit of speed.
Great, okay. And the other last benefit of the lighter shafts is just think about launch windows. So you could be a very strong, very quick player, but if you tend to launch shots really, really low, then light in an XLX could be actually a really good idea.
And that's a good thing there with KBS. There's so many options. If you are that golfer who has... not say quirky deliveries, but different deliveries.
Mm.
If you have plenty of speed, for instance, but tend to hit it quite low,
mm-hmm.
then normally what a lot of guys do would go, oh, he's got loads of speed, he'd be looking 130x.
Mm-hmm.
And that would be catastrophic if somebody's hit it already hit it quite low.
Okay, so all the shafts that we've talked about already, you typically tend to find them in a blade, a player's iron, and a player's distance iron. But that isn't the end of the KBS family. We also have the ultra lightweight iron shafts as well. So they're aimed at?
Yeah, so your mid handicap or your higher handicap, your slower swing speed, and again, a fantastic option there. You've got obviously the Max CT80, and this is great, I think, the future generation of the game. So for your juniors, the 560 and 580, so you can choose your category, and as you obviously develop through the game, you can just change.
Same feel.
Have the same feel right the way through your golfing career.
Okay. What I'd add in there is I've played the Max for the last 4 years in a set of Callaway Rogue X irons, and what I find it does for me personally, a player of 10, is that I'm able to launch a very strong lofted set of irons nice and high so they hit the green and stop. Okay, that isn't the end of the story. There's graphite as well. So the KBS have this huge family. When would you go graphite, Neil? Because it's not so, just about speed anymore.
Yeah, it's a little bit misunderstood, graphite, really. Everybody relates or links graphite to your slow swing speed. They get sometimes like your senior golfers, lady golfers, the guys who don't generally generate as much speed. Mm. But it's different now, really. If you can get the stability still in graphite. They do make the stronger flexes now with KBS, but if you want something that's easier on the body, less vibration up the shaft, mm-hmm. if you've got muscle or aches, pains, mm-hmm. I know a lot of golfers struggle with like wrist injuries, elbows. You can take a lot off that because you get a lot of vibration through steel shafts, as we know.
Okay, and that's something that's really important to point out, in my opinion, is that KBS, they target a steel feel from graphite.
Clever.
And I know there's been a number of tour players that have hit the tall graphite iron shaft and said, that's not graphite at all, that's a steel shaft, because they can't tell the difference between it. Just tell us a little bit about the fact that a lot of players, when you take the flex off, they actually prefer the feel of a graphite shaft compared to steel. You know, so if you don't know what the flex is, lots of players would prefer graphite over steel.
Feel. And I think that when I was hitting them, I did actually really like the feel of the graphite. It'd be interesting in the future for us to hit a few graphites with stronger shafts, with stronger flexes, sorry, maybe a little bit more weight. But I just feel like it's amazing that the KBS have like turned this corner of, graphite only fits the guy who's got slower swing speed. It's not the case. And like I say, I agree, they do feel like a steel shaft.
Okay, let's move on. Let's have a look at how all these shafts compare in data. Right, Neil, loads of data here. lots of people at home are going to go, hold on a second, they're all performing exactly the same. Yeah. That just isn't the case to how you felt.
No. The best example I can give to start, Sam, would be your KBS-C taper and the KBS-S taper. Now, if you were to look at the data, roughly, not too far off, the same numbers. Mm-hmm. But the difference in feel is phenomenal. If you said to me, now you have to go and play the C taper or use the S taper, I don't feel like I could use the C taper at all, but the S taper felt brilliant. Yeah. So this is where you've got to really consider the stability and the feel. Once you get that married up with the data that you're looking for, or the custom fitter that you're working with will look for you, you're on to a winner.
Yeah, and we sort of see that as well with the light. So they were faster, so the ball speed goes up. You know, there's lots of things that people need to consider, isn't there?
Yeah, like I say, the lighter options are seem to get a little bit quicker. Mm-hmm. Sometimes it go a little bit further because it'd be spinning a little bit less. Mm-hmm. If you can get all the numbers to work for you as the golfer, mm-hmm. and you get the stability and the feel from the shaft, you're going to be on to a winner. And I dare say, with that many options, you should be able to do that.
Yeah, I'd say at the end of the day, that KBS is all about the consumer. You know, you get what you want. And I love this story about Adam Scott and Gary Woodland. They both play the KBS shafts, but Adam Scott is playing the tour shaft, whereas Gary Woodland is playing the C taper. And if you switch their clubs over, they probably wouldn't be able to play golf very well because they wouldn't be getting the ball flight that they were expecting. Yeah. And that's what you get with KBS. You choose whether you want that lower launch, lower spin, whether you want the mid launch or higher launch. It's entirely down to you. And
difference
that's something that we
feel
get
is
out
phenomenal.
Of this. Okay. So just tell us a little bit then about which was your favourite model and why.
I've got to say S taper. Mm-hmm. Just felt workable enough, didn't feel too strong, but it also felt stable enough. I liked the feeling through the hands. I felt like I was in full control of it. Now people would say, oh, at your speeds, Neil, you'd probably fit down the C taper. It just felt too strong for me personally.
Okay.
So I think that's why it's important for you guys to try them. And as well, Simon, don't just grab any KBS shaft and just think that it's going to work for you, because you're not really doing KBS any justice in doing that. And think of all the hours of research, R&D, and there's a science behind this. And if you just get the wrong shaft for your golf game, it's not going to work.
Yeah, and they've got 14 models for a reason, you know, because there's something for everybody here. Just tell us a little bit about the graphite as well, because I know that the TGI, so the Tour, there has been Tour players that have tried it and gone, that isn't a graphite shaft. You know, it feels so much like a steel, they can't tell the difference.
It felt great. Well, you look at the TGI for me, in terms of data, ball speed 120, very good, launching at 16, 6-1 on the spin, and then the peak height and descent angle marry up to a 172. I mean, I could gain that probably. It felt really good.
Okay. And just to add in there, you need to think about your wedges as well, because KBS, they do make 5 different wedge shafts. So pay very, very close attention to if you're getting fitted for the KBS Iron Shafts, how do they flow through into your wedges? Really, really important point. Okay, guys, there's loads of information there. If you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.